NEXL is New England's premier paintball league. Stand by and get ready to enter the exciting world of tournament paintball. Dirty Water TV is next.
Going worldwide, Dirty Water.
And I love that Dirty Water TV.
Love that Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water. Dirty Water TV. Dirty
Water. I love that Dirty Water TV. I really do.
The best.
Ow!
Hey gang, LB here. I'm at Boston Paintball in Ashland, Mass, an amazing facility. It's Dirty Water TV, it's NEXL. I'm with the ex-professional paintballer and now commissioner of NEXL. Anthony Vitale and I are gonna break down an amazing match that went down between UConn and the Bandits and everything that's going on as far as the NEXL. An amazing facility, Boston Paintball here in Ashland, Mass. As you can see, something's going on behind me. We've got a plane, we've got structure. It seems like an apocalypse, Anthony?
Yes, what you're seeing is the beginning of Ashland's newest theme park, as we're trying to call it, is the Apocalypse City. You'll see planes, some wreckage, we've got the Deuce back there, and we're really trying to bring paintball to a new level and bring a movie set type atmosphere.
It's got to be probably one of the most amazing setups on the East Coast.
Yeah, we've been doing well here in New England as far as bringing it to a new level, but this is part of the area that we didn't excel at, so we're trying to up our game. You go across the country, there are a lot of better parks as far as scenarios.
Sure.
And bringing that, you know, realism, and
that's
what we're trying to do.
Yeah, whole town-like look, right? Whole city-like look, hence the Apocalypse City, LB. I get it. So, Anthony, like any professional league that's very successful run by an awesome commissioner, it gets bigger and better every year, so NEXL's expanded?
Yeah, for 2014, we added a new division. So we have the Elite Division this year, the Premier, we have the Race.
Sweet.
We also made a change to the format a little bit. So it went from Race to 4 points last year to Race to 5 this year. Still the same 12-minute time limit, so it's a little hybrid from what the national format is,
right.
But it works for us, and all the teams are excited.
Obviously, Dirty Water TV and NEXL have a great relationship. Dirty Water and Anthony are going to work together and cover each and every event in the new season. Last year was great, it was phenomenal, and this year is going to be even better, and Dirty Water TV is going to cover it right through to the New England Championship. And, you know, we're featuring UConn and the Bandits. Tell us a little bit about both teams in this amazing elite match.
Well, the Bay State Bandits are a new up-and-coming team. They're managed by Jeff Stein, the coach by Benny Carroll, so two ex-Hurricanes right there that are really experienced.
Sure.
Captained by Jake Eckersley. So,
Hey, wait. Eckersley, now, the Eck, are we talking ex-son?
We are, yep. Jake
wow.
Eckersley is the son
wow.
of Red Sox pitcher Dennis Eckersley.
The other team in this elite match is a bunch of college kids from UConn.
Yeah, the UConn Huskies, they're hot off of their runner-up finish in the NCAA championships. So they're ready to go. They bring a really fast-paced game,
sure,
so it'll be exciting.
They're college kids.
Right.
Us old people hate college kids.
They're pumped and ready to go.
But first, we're going to throw it to the goddess of Dirty Water TV, Sophia, and she's with the two captains.
Here now with Jake, captain of the Bandits, who will be taking on the UConn Huskies coming up here today. Tell me a little bit about your strategy going into today's game.
Well, we played UConn roughly 5-6 weeks ago down in Connecticut, and we saw a lot of really good success playing from them. This layout plays a lot slower than what we've seen from past layouts, so we're going to try and take it at our own pace and let them come to us. There's a lot of places to hide, and we're going to let them make mistakes.
How are you forming your strategy around not only the new league you're playing in, but you're going to be taking on the Bandits here soon? Where are your heads at going into this game?
Okay, well, we had the opportunity to practice them, I don't know, maybe 6 weeks ago. So there's a little familiarity. We're going to play our paintball, aggressive yet smart. We're not the kind of team that you're going to see sit back and shoot 10 pods of paint. We're going to go out there. I tell my guys to go out there with 4 pods. If you need more than that, we're not going to win the point because that's not UConn paintball. UConn paintball is fast, aggressive, beat them up quick.
Yo,
go. Good movement up there. Where'd you shop?
Coming up, let the games begin. We head to the field for the elite match between the Yukon Huskies and the Bay State Bandits. You're watching the NEXL on Dirty Water TV.
What up? Nikki Cuba from LA Infamous.
Nick Shlodak, Houston Heat.
And I'm Ryan Greenspan from San Diego Dynasty. We love Dirty Water TV.
We love Dirty Water TV.
Love it. Dirty Water TV.
Bam.
Equipment Depot has been serving contractors since 1992.
Hi, I'm Depot Girl Brittany, and here at Test Equipment Depot, we have the right testing tools for you at the best prices around.
Test Equipment Depot is a broadline distributor carrying all the top manufacturers, including Fluke,
like the Fluke T5-1000 electrical tester or the Fluke 62 Max infrared thermometer.
Like any electrician, I work hard for my money, and I find that it's better spent at Test Equipment Depot.
Log on to testequipmentdepot.com today.
I'm committed.
Boston Paintball has been committed since 1992, providing New England with an unrivaled paintball experience. With three locations, including New England's largest indoor facility in Chelsea, the newest multi-use playing center in Ashland, and the tournament-tested home in Maynard, Boston Paintball has your field of battle covered. Visit Committed Paintball, Boston Paintball's official online pro shop. Buy online now at committedpaintball.com. Get in the game at Boston Paintball because they're committed.
This family's radiator overheated, and they called locally owned Preferred Automotive of Weymouth, where Dean and his tow truck responded immediately. This family called a tow and took their car to the big chain repair shop, where they waited and waited. Meanwhile, Preferred fixed the radiator, inspected the car, and had the family back on the road to Cape Cod for fun in the sun. Like their overheated radiator, the other family continued to steam. Make the right call. Preferred Automotive. 781-331-8944.
Edition of Dirty Water News at over 300 news boxes throughout the city. Get all the latest nightlife news you can use. Dirty Water News is also available online at dirtywaternews.com.
This portion of Dirty Water TV is brought to you by Preferred Auto and Tire of Weymouth, the alternative to dealerships.
Hey gang, LB, we're back here at Boston Paintball. Welcome back to Dirty Water TV. It's that time. I'm excited. I'm fired up. 2014 NEXL season is here. Anthony Vitale, commissioner of the NEXL, going to kick it off.
And let's send it to our feature match between the Yukon Huskies and the Bay State Bandits. Both teams starting out with a very similar breakout, but the Bandits are doing a much better job edging out and quickly eliminate the Yukon player going snakeside. There goes another elimination for the Bandits from the Dorito corner, leaving both corners vacant for the Huskies. Huskies' Grant Bedard taking ground to get a better angle to slow the Bandits' assault. Grant battling down the tape and loses that battle down the wire and is eliminated. Sean Wyatt quickly makes the move to the race center while the back center can is being pinched out. John and the rest of the Bandits team relay to Dorito 1 as the last man standing and quickly eliminate him to secure the first point.
All righty, we have a good hang. 11 minutes even on the game clock, 1:30 to the point, and the Bay State Bandits are up 1-0.
UConn playing more conservatively, leaving two at home, matching the Bandits from point one. Neither team took Snake off the break. Bandits player wins his gun battle, eliminating UConn and his potential Snake threat. We have the ref going in to check a Bandits player in the Dorito, and he's signaling him clean. So at this point, we have two in the Dorito, two in the back center, and one for each team looking to get in the Snake. Bandits player is eliminated. Sean Wyatt once again making an aggressive move to the race, turning all the guns inside. The Bandits are moving wide down the Dorito side, all caused by that center pressure put on by Sean Wyatt. Sean quickly captures an elimination while in the center race as well. Sean now sitting, posting, waiting for a mistake. The game quickly becomes a two-on-one, which is what you're always trying to create to gain that advantage. Bandits moving down the field and quickly clean up, and they take point two.
With 8:59 left on the game clock, we have scored 2-0. Bay State Bandits over the UConn Huskies.
Bandits trying to take a little more ground than the previous points and lose a player in the process. UConn capitalizing on one less gun in Laner and takes the corner. Pat O'Brien holding down that lane. Bandit player Kyle Nicolou taking the race early, again trying to rotate those guns inside. UConn's Grant Bedard, knowing the damage that Kyle can cause in that race, moves up to the Dorito 2. He's trying to get a better angle for that potential critical elimination. Meanwhile, Bandit player number 9 does exactly what he's supposed to do, playing off of Kyle in the race and running through the UConn players looking inside.
All right, UConn concedes that point. With 8:02 left on the game clock, it is now 3-0 Bay State Bandits.
Bandits come out guns hot as they did in points 1 and 2. UConn has a very similar breakout as the previous points, with two in the Rito, two in the center, and one on the Snake side looking to get in. Oh, UConn gets a penalty on the stand-up. He took one in the arm, continued to play, eliminating another player. Oh, looks like a second actually is being eliminated as well. Now the Bandits sense that and take some massive ground and quickly close out the point. Making it an uphill battle, it is now 4-0 with only 1 point left to close out this race to five match.
UConn concedes, giving the Bandits a 4-0 lead. A minute and 30 to the point, 7:08 on the game clock.
The Bandits edge out two in the center, but UConn player avoids the lane and takes the race off the break. Now the Bandits are in unfamiliar territory. UConn getting aggressive now, putting the Bandits on their heels. They're stuck in their back original bunkers. Staying low, UConn player Chris Mapley doing damage just by staying alive. UConn realizing it's a lot easier to move with Mapley's center presence. Let's see if they can get wide and capitalize. Bandit player sees the opportunity to trade cleanly and does. A much needed move to even have a chance to come back in this point. UConn fills the center. UConn pinching out and causing those two-on-one battles. Great comeback point by UConn to stop the bleeding and maybe swing some momentum their way.
All right, UConn fighting back, takes that point from the Bay State Bandits. It's now 4-1 with 5:12 left on the game clock.
UConn, real aggressive breakout, taking the race once again. UConn's doing a really great job of running and gunning, taking an elimination from the Bandits. Chris Mapley getting real aggressive moving into that pin. Usually I would like to see him be a little more calm in there, but maybe he sees an elimination. Chris wins the gunfight, making me eat my words and eliminating a Bandit player. UConn during this play moved uniformly down the field, eliminating the last of the Bandit players.
And another good point. So the Huskies battle back. It's 4-2, 4:17 left on the game clock, 1:30 to the point.
Coming up, see if the UConn Huskies can complete the comeback. You're watching the NEXL on Dirty Water TV.
Family's radiator overheated and they called locally owned Preferred Automotive of Weymouth, where Dean and his tow truck responded immediately. This family called a tow and took their car to the Big Chain repair shop, where they waited and waited. Meanwhile, Preferred fixed the radiator, inspected the car, and had the family back on the road to Cape Cod for fun in the sun. Like their overheated radiator, the other family continued to steam. Make the right call. Preferred Automotive. 781-331-8944.
I'm committed.
Boston Paintball has been committed since 1992, providing New England with an unrivaled paintball experience. With three locations, including New England's largest indoor facility in Chelsea, the newest multi-use playing center in Ashland, and the tournament-tested home in Maynard. Boston Paintball has your field of battle covered. Visit Committed Paintball, Boston Paintball's official online pro shop. Buy online now at committedpaintball.com. Get in the game at Boston Paintball because they're committed.
Test Equipment Depot has been serving contractors since 1992. Hi, I'm Depot Girl Brittany, and here at Test Equipment Depot, we have the right testing tools for you at the best prices around. Test Equipment Depot is a broadline distributor carrying all the top manufacturers, including Fluke, like the Fluke T5-1000 electrical tester or the Fluke 62 Max infrared thermometer.
Like any electrician, I work hard for my money, and I find that it's better spent at Test Equipment Depot.
Log on to testequipmentdepot.com today. Up-to-the-minute nightlife information, log on to DirtyWaterTV.com, and it's your go-to place for everything hot and happening in New England. From blogs to video, DirtyWaterTV.com has you covered with the most informative nightlife news. That's DirtyWaterTV.com.
This portion of Dirty Water TV is brought to you by Test Equipment Depot, providing the finest test equipment solution since 1992. It's where the contractors go. TestEquipmentDepot.com.
Do you have any advice for young kids that are just starting out and looking to, you know, become like you?
Yeah, I do. Just go to your local paintball fields. Latch onto the hip of one of the guys that are older, know what they're doing. Stay right behind them. Practice, just like any other sport. Practice and train.
You just have to have the drive every day. It gets very frustrating. You are getting shot at. It does hurt sometimes, but you just have to never give up.
For anyone looking even just to get into paintball, if they want to do it, just do it. Like, you can compete in any division. You're gonna learn a lot and everything. So recommend to even any new players, just go and do it.
Get out there and play. Like I said, start at a birthday party. Get a few local kids around. Get your parents. Get your ride down there. Play. Have fun.
Welcome back to Dirty Water TV, and the Bandits got it going on up 4-0. UConn marches back. They get a couple. It's 4-2. What are the chances here for the college kids, Anthony?
I'm anything's possible. I definitely think that what they were doing at the end there to bring it back to 4-2 was obviously in the right direction. They are going to need to mix it up, though, because the Bay State Bandits are going to make an adjustment, and they can't bring in the same play each time. So if they can bring a different play, move quickly, I think they still have a chance.
All right, man. Well, let's get back to the match, the NEXL Elite Match of the Day.
UConn comes out with the breakout that got them back in this match. Bandits counter, edging out the UConn back player, Snakeside. See if Chris Mapley can even out the count here with a quick elimination. Oh, UConn player loses his gunfight, putting the Bandits up 5-3. Gonna be hard for Chris to play out of the race with five players looking to eliminate him and only two guns supporting him. Oh, not Chris's best decision to leave the race with that many guns on. The Bandits are playing a solid point with all the five players doing their jobs. Looks like congratulations to the Bandits as they close this match out 5-2.
Alrighty, a great match. UConn made a valiant effort to come back from a big 4-0 deficit, but in the end, it was a 5-2 victory for the Bay State Bandits. Alrighty, committed start to the game. Brought to you by Committed Paintball. The first star goes to UConn Husky player Rob Runowitz. The two star goes to the Bandit player Sean White. Star player of the game for Committed Paintball goes to the Bandit Kyle Nicolou.
Wow, you can't ask for much more than that in the opening match of the NEXL. We're back. I'm with the commissioner, Anthony Vitale. How about that one? That was a match and a half.
Yeah, when you thought that it was just going to be a complete 4-0, 5-0 match, UConn definitely, you know, said that they're here to play this year.
That's for sure. Bay State went out 4-0, and UConn fought, and you got to give the kids credit for not giving up. And hey, that's what it's all about. It's a team sport. You got to be there right to the end.
And they absolutely were. You're going to see good things from UConn this year. But again, congratulations to the Bay State Band. It's a well-played match.
Awesome. And that said, let's go back to Sophia with some post-game reaction.
All right, here now with Ben, coach of the Bandits. Tell me a little bit about your strategy that you wanted your team to bring to this match.
You know, we watched them the last match they played over here. We got to see kind of what they were doing. We didn't really change much from the match before us. What we saw them do actually fed perfectly into our game plan. We used the X a little bit. We used our snake guys delaying. It was a pretty stock play, but it just worked well.
All right, Sean, tell me a little bit about the match that went on here. What worked for you guys? What didn't work? You know, you were up 4, down 2, you know. Tell me a little bit about what was going on out there.
Yeah, we had a really aggressive style of play in the beginning. We matched up with them really well. We came up really well, 4-0. They rallied back. A lot of respect to UConn, really good players. Came back 2 points, but just wasn't enough. We end up closing out strong and finished 5-2.
All right, Nick, tell me a little bit about the match. It was a tough loss for you guys, but you guys did come back with 2.
I think they had us just figured out from the beginning. They're a good team. They stay behind their guns. They know how to shoot. It just took us too long to figure them out. And it's classic UConn paintball going down. And when you're playing college paintball, there's no cap. You don't play to 5. You play till the time is over. So we're used to going down 4 points, coming back, having time to play with. And here at NEXL, it's a lot. Just the format's a lot different. We're not used to it.
Awesome. Now, what's next for you guys? You got to pick yourselves back up and get back out there. What's next?
We have one more game today. I don't think we're going to be able to make the playoffs, but I mean, the least we could do is go out there and show these guys what we're made of. We're not going to go quietly. We have paint left, and we got heart, so we're not going to give up.
Up next, we'll wrap things up from the NEXL. That's when Dirty Water TV returns.
I'm committed.
Boston Paintball has been committed since 1992, providing New England with an unrivaled paintball experience. With three locations, including New England's largest indoor facility in Chelsea, the newest multi-use playing center in Ashland, and the tournament-tested home in Maynard, Boston Paintball has your field of battle covered. Visit Committed Paintball, Boston Paintball's official online pro shop. Buy online now at committedpaintball.com. Get in the game at Boston Paintball because they're committed.
Test Equipment Depot has been serving contractors since 1992. Hi, I'm Depot Girl Brittany, and here at Test Equipment Depot, we have the right testing tools for you at the best prices around. Test Equipment Depot is a broadline distributor carrying all the top manufacturers, including Fluke, like the Fluke T5-1000 electrical tester or the Fluke 62 Max infrared thermometer.
Like any electrician, I work hard for my money, and I find that it's better spent at Test Equipment Depot.
Log on to testequipmentdepot.com today.
This family's radiator overheated, and they called locally owned Preferred Automotive of Weymouth, where Dean and his tow truck responded immediately. This family called a tow and took their car to the big chain repair shop, where they waited and waited. Meanwhile, Preferred fixed the radiator, inspected the car, and had the family back on the road to Cape Cod for fun in the sun. Like their overheated radiator, the other family continued to steam. Make the right call. Preferred Automotive, 781-331-8944.
Welcome back. What a weekend of action. You know, it's never always about just an elite match in the NEXL. It's about a weekend of games, and there was a bunch of winners this weekend.
Yeah, we had three divisions, and it was a well-fought match in all three. You had New England Invasion.
Yeah.
They defeated Section 8, which is last year's best of New England champ, so that's a great win for Invasion.
Yeah.
Then we had Grind in the Premier Division with a win over last year's D4 champions, Rod Squad. So again, that's going to be a grind all year long for them. But that was a great match. And then in the race division, it was a battle of New York teams. So Long Island won with Hi-Fi Wrecking Crew beating New York Infectious. So it's going to be a great year.
There's so much that goes on in the NEXL during an event. Talk about the people that are behind you and the support system you have.
Yeah, our sponsors are really unparalleled. We have great support from Empire Paintball, Planet Eclipse, our local sponsors, Test Equipment Depot, Preferred Automotive. Without this, without staff, without Laurie, this event doesn't happen.
Well, and without Dirty Water TV, I'll be in Sofia. I mean, not for nothing. It's about paintball. It's about the NEXL. The next event, June 1st, you got to be there. Maynard, Mass., Boston Paintball. It's on NEXL, Dirty Water TV. Anthony, the commissioner of the greatest paintball league in the planet, and myself, I'll be the newest, greatest paintball fan. I'm trying to think of something.
I think it's the tagline.
Yeah, what would that be?
The weekend may be over.
But the party never ends on Dirty Water TV. Booyah.
Hey. This is Mark Wahlberg. I love that Dirty Water TV.
Dirty Water TV spotlights all that's hot and happening in Boston, from the bars and nightclubs to music, events, and celebrities.
I love that Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water TV.
Now you can catch twice as much Dirty Water TV on NESN.
And I love that Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water TV.
Every Saturday night and now Sunday night too at 11:30 p.m. because the party never ends on Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water TV. Dun, dun, dun.